Well, happy site owners and webmasters, Mayanna here with an update on the social share button plugins post. I sure hope you've seen this today, man. It took me a while to do these tests. They are very deep. It's a 120-page report. I checked it for everything. And you can see the full list down here of all the free plugins that I tested. Now, I'm going to be testing the paid versions of these as well. That's what's coming up next. Plus, Pinterest support, because you know that's part of the reason for getting the paid plugins, is you want that extra Pinterest support. And Kate All is going to be coming to help with that. You know, man, if you know anything about Pinterest, you know Kate All. And she's going to be helping with those tests. And that's what's coming next. But it's only going to be on the top winners of these free plugins. I'm not buying all these that didn't do well and whatever. So you definitely want to look in this post and see what's going on with the plugin that you use. Clear winners, clear plugins to run away from. Ooh. Okay, so one of the top winners, of course, is Scriptless Social Sharing. This is what I've got on BlogAid. Looks a whole lot like this. But made an update to this post because I didn't realize, you know, I had my theme revamped back in the summer, and I didn't realize that my designer had done a little magic on this for mobile, and that this plugin by nature doesn't work the same way on mobile for y'all if you take out some of these heavyweight things that would load your site and whatever. So I went and asked her, I said, hey Marcy, what did you do? And look here, I want you to see the update that I did on this post down here. Okay, for these settings, these are the default settings, and it looks like this, and these little icons and stuff. She uses those things for mobile, too. And so when you take those out, if you set it like this, where I showed you how to make it really fast, you just load the main style sheet. Well, guess what? It's not going to give you your icons. You're not going to have any fonts on the buttons on mobile. They'll look fine on desktop. But to get mobile, you need to do one of these two things, not both, one of these. Either add a little CSS, and we've got that for you here to your themes CSS file, your style sheet, right? Or if you use the customizer to do additional CSS, some themes have that now, then you need to do it that way. But you don't want to do the additional CSS if your theme didn't already have it, because it probably will create another call. And that defeats the whole purpose. So one of these two ways. If you have questions about that, check with your designer for it. And thank you so much to Marcy Diaz. And I'm going to go ahead and bring this up here so you can see it, because I want to give her all the kudos for this. She knew the magic behind it. She did it for me as well. And so here it is, the CSS that you need to add. So it's not much to it, but, and it's not hard to do if you know what you're doing with your theme style or talk to your designer. It's 5 or 10 minute thing to do it. And then your buttons will look like this on mobile and desktop. How about that? So come on over to BlogAid and see these two very important posts. Please do share them with your friends, because you definitely want all the speed and security that you can get. Some of these plugins have things that you're not going to like, and you need to see where yours stacks up against these deep tests. It's not all about fashion. You got to look at function as well. Coming over to the BlogAid Facebook page, that's where I'm live streaming, and about to check in and see if I've got any questions over there. And I'll see you online.